ऑटोमोबाइल की जानकारी पाने के लिए क्लिक कर दीजिए इस लाल कलर के सब्सक्राइब वाले बटन को, और बेल आइकन को भी जरूर क्लिक कर दीजिए नोटिफिकेशंस को सबसे पहले पाने के लिए।
वी ऑल नो दैट द ऑटोमोबाइल इंजन्स आर वेरी वेरी पॉल्यूटिंग, सो टू कंट्रोल द पॉल्यूशन एंड द एमिशन ऑफ द ऑटोमोबाइल इंजन्स वी यूज सेवरल डिवाइसेस दैट आर नोन एज द कैटालिटिक कन्वर्टर। So this is the topic that we are going to discuss in our whole video. So please keep watching this video. You are going to learn everything about the catalytic converter. If you did not subscribe my channel yet, please click on the subscribe button at this moment and don't forget to click on that bell sign to get notified. Okay, let's start with the catalytic converter. First of all, the composition of the exhaust gases are: nitrogen is about 70%, carbon dioxide is 40%, and water is about 13%. Oxygen is about 10%, that is only in the diesel engines. NOx is about 0.25%, carbon monoxide is about 2%, and sulfur dioxide is about 0.02%. So that these are the compositions of the exhaust gases. So these are the gases that are required to be treated before getting into the atmosphere. Now we use the catalytic converter. The catalytic converter is also known as a three-way converter because it reduces carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, hydrocarbon, and NOx. So these are the three gases that are treated by this catalytic converter. So this is a major advantage that a single device can treat the three major pollutants of the exhaust gases. So coming to the structure of this catalytic converter, the structure consists of a porous ceramic structure, or it may be a loose granular structure. The loose granular ceramic structure consists of a porous cloth in which these granules are filled up and the gases, exhaust gases, are passed through these. Now the material of this ceramic structure or the porous ceramic structure is the aluminum oxide. So is the aluminum oxide. This is also known as the alumina. We use this because it can withstand high temperature, it is chemically neutral at high temperature, and it has very low thermal expansion and no thermal degradation, because most of the material don't have all these four properties. So that's why you use alumina. The volume of the catalytic converter, that is the porous catalytic converter, required is equal to the half of the volume of the cylinder displacement. This is the approximate calculated value of the volume of the catalytic converter. This is done so as to achieve the volume flow rate such that about 5 to 30 changeovers can take place in a single second. Now coming to the basic reaction that occurs inside the engine, that is the petrol is a basic hydrocarbon. And at the time of the fire or the burning of this petrol, the oxidation of this hydrocarbon occurs that leads to the formation of carbon dioxide and water. These the major pollutants that must occurring must be carbon dioxide and water. But what happens is, due to the very frequent cycles of the engine, the complete oxidation of carbon is not going to occur. So what happens is that the carbon monoxide is formed in place of the carbon dioxide in some of the molecules of the carbon dioxide. Now the other gases that are inside the atmospheric air are nitrogen, oxygen, and sulfur. So what happens is, due to high temperature, some of the times nitrogen also gets oxidized and form NOx gases. Some of time sulfur also get oxidized and form sulfur trioxide. So this is the basic diagram of the catalytic converter. Here this point of this catalytic converter is connected to the engine and exhaust manifold, and the exhaust gases are coming through this. This is the porous ceramic structure through which the exhaust gases are going to pass, and this is towards the silencer. So looking from the other side of this catalytic converter, you can see like this mesh like structure, and these are the pores through which the gases are going to pass through this catalytic converter. So this catalytic converter, the material that we use is for the structure of this catalytic converter. But for the treatment of these gases, we use some catalyst. So these catalysts can be the platinum, palladium, and rhodium. So these platinum, palladium, or rhodium are going to be used on the walls of these pores, or this catalytic converter is going to be dipped inside these chemicals, and they and taken out, and after some treating and heat treatment, this after that it is going to be used. So this platinum, palladium, and rhodium, in this platinum and palladium are used for the oxidation of carbon monoxide and some hydrocarbons, and rhodium is used to the reaction of the NOx gases. So what happens is, There are several reactions that are going to take place inside this catalytic converter. That is, the NO and CO are going to form. It may form half of the NO, it may form ammonia, it may form nitrogen oxide, or if the NO is going to react with the hydrogen, it can form N2, NH3 and N2O. If the CO, like the carbon monoxide, is going to react with water, but it can make its carbon dioxide and hydrogen. So these are the several reactions that may take place in the catalytic converter. So these are the reactions that are going to occur inside the catalytic converter. Platinum, palladium and rhodium are going to boost up these reactions and increase the rate of these reactions. Now coming to the efficiency of this catalytic converter, so there is a graph from which you can just estimate the efficiency of this catalytic converter. So in this graph here is the efficiency bar and this is the temperature axis. So this is the concentration of carbon monoxide, hydrocarbon and NOx. So from here you can see, easily observe that as the temperature increases, the efficiency also increases, and hence the efficiency directly proportional to the temperature. So that's why it is advisable to use these catalytic converters at high temperature. Now coming to the life of these catalytic converters, the life of this catalytic converter is said to be the life of the automobile. So because the life of this catalytic converter is about 2 lakh kilometers, so that is the average life of an automobile. So that's why it is said the life of the catalytic converter is about the life of the automobile engines. The life is restricted to several period. This is because there may occur the thermal degradation of this porous ceramic structure and the poisoning of the catalyst that is used in this catalytic converter. Now coming to the effect of the sulfur, because sulfur is also a gas inside the atmosphere, it may affect this catalytic converter, because sulfur dioxide can also oxide when this catalytic converter is working. It is oxidizing all these gases, so it can also oxidize sulfur dioxide and form a sulfur trioxide, and this sulfur trioxide can form later on form sulfuric acid and fall as the acid rain. And this sulfuric acid is also harmful for the degradation of this catalytic converter. So there is a problem inside this catalytic converter, that it is not going to work that much efficiently at lower temperature. So at cold starting, it is advisable to use a preheating. So the authorities decided to use a preheater. There are 5 ways in which the preheating can be done. Placement of this catalytic converter near the engine. Another preheating is the super insulation, insulating the catalytic converter. Electric heating, using electric heater. Flame heating, flame using a flame, and thermal battery that is producing some temperature. So I think this is all about the catalytic converter. If you still have any doubts in any way, you can please ask me in the comment section below. I am waiting for your comments and I'm going to reply each and every comment that is in the comment section below. Thanks a lot guys for watching my video. Keep watching, keep sharing and keep supporting guys. Thanks a lot guys.